Hi there! In this episode, I'm gonna build the Tamiya P-47D Razorback in 48 scale. Enjoy! This is one of my favorite kits in 48 scale. I still remember the huge interest on this kit when it was released in 2002. Maybe this is why I still think this is a new kit for me. This is understandable, because this kit is beyond its era. Flawless fitting with smartly designed parts are highly detailed and molded perfectly. You can build 4 or 5 of this kit in the same time. I highly recommend this kit to beginners or you if you haven't built yet. Okay, let's get started. I have built this kit before a few times, so instead of starting from the cockpit first, I will first prepare the parts that will be painted in the same color and divide them into groups. If you are building an NMF model, cleaning and leveling of parts properly is very important. So I'm cleaning the old excess pieces and molding lines carefully. Some parts are needed to be glued before painting. This part is the lower half of the left wing. Let's see how it's designed perfectly for multiple versions of the aircraft. It's impossible to not use the pieces I glued on. Just amazing. Don't forget to drill the holes on the underwing for the pylons and loadout. In my opinion, making weighted effect with heat on tires too risky. For that, I prefer aftermarket parts or this. I'm carving the ejector pin marks with a knife first. And then I'm softening the scratches on the surface with liquid glue. Aligning of this piece needs some attention. I'm masking the outer frames in my usual way. Finally, all the parts are ready to paint. I group them like this will be painted with bronze green, black, and chromate yellow. And don't forget to paint these areas with chromate yellow too. I'm painting the canopy frames with the cockpit color first. And I'm painting the details with a brush. Actually, doing this is easier than it seems. The decals are not in good condition because the kit I have is a bit old. That's why I did this a little bit hard. I fixed the seat belt decals to an aluminum foil sheet before this step. For more details, check out my Stuka build video. I applied a layer of X22 before this. Now I'm using the Tamiya dark brown weathering wash. I'm wiping the excess wash with turpentine. I'm applying dry brush for highlighting the details to become visible. And finally, I'm finishing the job with the matte varnish. I'm adding the glass effect with X22. At the last stage, I paint the details that I want to be glossy and bright. The cockpit tube ready for the final assembly. Double check the instructions before closing the fuselage to avoid forget to glue pieces like this. Okay, it's ready for the assembly. Let's fix the engine to its place. This is the only negative point of kit. But not big deal. I'm applying putty on the ejector pin marks. Even the smallest scratches become visible on metallic surfaces. So I will do the sanding work more carefully. Luckily, I have these amazing sanding sponges. The wings fit into place like a piece of Lego. No need to do anything other than apply glue. Those black sponges that come with the detail sets are very useful for this job. I'm starting the paint job with black primer first. This primer is semi-gloss. That doesn't matter much because I will use the Tamiya X22 acrylic varnish to get glossy surface. I will use this sponge on the next steps of the build. Keep this in mind. Before applying every varnish layer, I'm sanding the surface because I want to achieve shiny and flawless surface like a car model. And I'm applying the first layer of X22 gloss varnish. I applied a few thin layer of gloss varnish and I sanded every layer. And then it's time to polishing the surface with compound. I think that's enough. I cleaned the model thoroughly under running water with a soft brush. Make sure the compound is completely clean to avoid problems. Finally, I can apply the metallic paint. Hello viewers, this message comes from the past. We are facing difficult times due to infectious virus and postal services are disrupted. Therefore, I will paint this model with the only paint I have left, Alclad Chrome. I know more metallic tone gives more realistic effect. I will try that with only one paint. Yep, that's the challenge. I know these paints are not buffable type. But that doesn't mean they won't dust. So I'm wiping gently after the paint has dried. It seems things are starting to get more awkward for you. Yes, I'm polishing the surface with Moto Tool. I will complete this process in minutes. You can do it with a soft cotton cloth, but that takes a few hours. Painting defects appeared after the polishing process. Now I'm applying the repair paint. I will apply the same polish process over on them. I left the model for a few days to dry chemically. I can use masking tape safely. Now I'm painting the remaining details. To paint white before red is an old trick. I preferred matte paints to avoid problems when removing masks between the paint layers. So I have to apply X22 gloss layer over on them. I realize at this stage that I bought a defective product. This is a Tecmo decal set and I bought it from Hannibal's. Anyway, I can fix that, but it is not moral at all to bring the defective product to the market. Anyway, Tecmo decals are awesome, especially on metallic surfaces. It's time to post-shade weathering. When the shooting was finished, I realized that nothing is visible due to the angle of the camera. I've added the most visible parts in this video, so this face is a little short. I will solve this problem in my next videos, sorry about that. I'm applying semi-matte varnish on non-metallic surfaces and on the decals only. I'm painting the navigation lights and glue them in place with the X22. Let's do something cool. I'm applying a layer of hairspray over the metallic painted rocket launchers and a heavy coat of olive drab. After a few hours, a warm bath and scrubs. Dust effect with soft pastels. I painted with gunmetal color these spread drilled gun barrels. Let's add the final details and finish this. Well, thanks for watching this episode. If you liked the video, please like and share. Subscribe my channel if you haven't yet. Also, you can support my channel if you can see the join button below or on Patreon. The links are in the information section below. See you soon on the next episode. Until then, take care of yourself and keep modeling. Bye.